There are many misconceptions in Islam, and people always point a finger that why does Islam subjugate the woman by keeping her in the veil? And if we analyze that, who is to decide what is modest? The Quran says in Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 30, say to the believing man that he should lower his gaze and guard his modesty. That whenever a man looks at a woman, any brazen thought comes in his mind, he should lower his gaze. Next verse, Surah Nur, chapter number 24, verse number 31 says, say to the believing woman that she should lower her gaze and guard her modesty, and display not her beauty except what appears ordinary of, and draw her veil over the bosom, and display not her beauty except in front of her father, her husband, her son, then a big list of mahram is given. Basically, there are six criteria for hijab, which is given in the Quran and the Hadith. The first is the extent. For the man, from navel to the knee. For the woman, the complete body should be covered. The only part that can be seen are the face and hands up to the wrist. There are many scholars who say that even this should be covered. The remaining five criteria are the same. The second is the clothes they wear, it should not be tight so that it reveals the figure. Third, it should not be transparent. Fourth, it should not be so glamorous so that it attracts the opposite sex. Fifth, it should not resemble and be a sign of the unbeliever. And sixth, it should not resemble that of the opposite sex. Similarly, if you read Hindu scriptures, it's mentioned in Rig Veda, book number 8, hymn number 33, verse number 19. It says, Brahma has made you a dame, made you a lady. So therefore, cast down your eyes and do not look up. Put your feet together and let not your garment reveal what your veil conceals. So according to Rig Veda, book number 8, hymn number 33, verse number 19, it says that the woman should lower the gaze. They should not stare at the opposite sex, and they should wear a veil. Further, it's mentioned in Rig Veda, book number 10, hymn number 85, verse number 30, that it is devilish and not right when a husband, he covers his thighs with the garments of his wife. That means wearing clothes of opposite sex is prohibited in Hinduism. It's further mentioned in Mahavir Charit, Act number 2, page number 71, when Sri Ram, when he sees Parushuram, he tells his wife Sita that Parushuram, he is our elder. You cast thy eyes and draw the veil. So Sri Ram tells his wife Sita that when the elder comes, you should draw the veil and look down. Further, if you read the books of historical records, we find the Indian ladies, many of them wear veils. There are coins in the post-Gupta age, showing women, Indian women, wearing a veil, and the veil coming up to the shoulders, some up to the arms. Even today, if you go in many Indian villages, we find that women, they cover the head. Some of them even cover their face. So here, if we analyze the modesty level of a woman in Islam and Hinduism, is the same, that they have to be covered up.